Hello, everybody. We are here today because another tragedy took place. Because some lives are considered less than others in value. Because the world turns a blind eye when some people's children are burned to death, while others, if a bomb falls 10 kilometers away from their house, the world stands up and doesn't sit down. But why are we bringing these tragedies to these peaceful streets of Montreal? Are we importing a problem where a problem should not exist? No, we are not. Because this kind of attitude and a great infrastructure of support of this attitude starts here in Montreal as much as it starts in many cities in the Western world, where there is a Zionist lobby that is strong and that enforces support for these crimes, but none like what we have here in Canada, where a part of this lobby is the Prime Minister and the government of the country itself. I prefer, if we think, so what can we do other than be here to voice our condemnation, our anger, our disgust, our refusal for these practices? And yes, there is something we can do, and that something is called, let us vote on the 19th of October to make sure that this Zionist Prime Minister is no more in power come the 20th of October. Let us be proactive. Let us not only come and gather when a child is being burned, because every day, day in and day out, there are a whole people that are being burned, that are being stripped from their rights, that are being treated as subhuman, that are being treated with indignity, and we tend to forget, except when a ferocious act like what happened a few days ago happened. This should not be the case. Let us be always alert and always awake and always active to make sure that we, through our Canadian government, through our voice here in Canada, can enforce justice rather than hate, injustice rather than abide by what our current Prime Minister makes us abide by and makes us partners in a crime. We do not expect that we or any Canadian would accept that, and we don't buy any of these arguments that Israel is defending itself or its security. Israel is just caring for expansion. It is just caring for subjugating people to fulfill its own goal. And any honorable, any righteous people and government would not support Israel in the way, or in any way, let alone the way the Harper is supporting it. Thank you very much.